my sons. Bag up off me and watch you lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving mad and glued. And if you choose to run up on me, you gon' get laid out so fast. Cause I can get you with the run or I can hit you with the pass. Touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0. Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard. My team is.
Hey everybody, it's the coach. This is a special edition of Wild Card Weekend on EA Sports. Up next, we've got what ought to be a great matchup between the Green Bay Packers and the New Orleans Saints. With that, let's get over to the Mercedes-Benz SuperDome with a call from New Orleans. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to a sold-out and absolutely rocking Mercedes-Benz SuperDome in downtown New Orleans. Straight ahead, it's Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a great one in store between the Green Bay Packers and the New Orleans Saints. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the postseason on EA Sports. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And Charles, that's really all I need to say to get you fired up. It's the postseason on EA Sports.
And no one's more fired up than the guys who are going to be playing in this game. This is what they fought for all year long. Go back to the OTAs, the mini camps, training camp, throughout the season to get to the playoffs. The intensity level will be off the charts.
What twists and turns will January have in store for us? The NFL playoffs are officially underway. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. They'll be taken out by the product of the University of Louisville, the talented Teddy Bridgewater.
His stature isn't huge. He's not one of the big, strong-arm guys that you see coming into the league. But his touch, decision-making, ability to make plays, that's why Teddy Bridgewater has a chance to be a top quarterback in the league.
They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And that is the kind of tackling they want to see all game, as he'll lose yardage to start things out. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
On second and 11 now, Bridgewater, they'll set up the screen now to Kamara. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
It's gonna be a long day. It's gonna be a long day.
On second and 11 now, Bridgewater, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. And a look now at the offense for New Orleans.
So many weapons on this offense, and we've seen them all season long score from any point on the field. But we all know playoff football comes down to playing smart. The game slows down, and it's harder to move it. So you've got to avoid penalties, avoid turnovers, and not let your emotions get the best of you.
And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 34-yard line. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 34. To throw, Bridgewater completes this one to Meredith. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal. Bridgewater now. And that's off the mark, incomplete. We'll take a look at the starters here defensively for the Packers. They were terrific a week ago in the win over the Lions.
Yeah, they gave up 17 points, but that's about what you consider the break-even mark. If you give up 17 points a game all year long, you're thinking you're going to be a playoff team. That's what you're looking for. Room to improve, of course, but pretty nice effort.
And just one man in the backfield here. That's Kamara, second and goal. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Josh Hill there to make the grab as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. So they take the opening kickoff and drive it all the way down the field.
And that's the last thing you want defensively. On the road, in the playoffs, and now you're down a touchdown right away.
Will Lutz on for the point after. And it's good as the Saints have a 7-0 lead. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. So now it's the Packers' turn to go on offense for the first time. They'll be led out by their highly decorated quarterback, Aaron Rodgers.
So pinpoint, so accurate. Sometimes we forget just how good he is. We start to take him for granted because he always places the ball exactly where it needs to be for his receivers.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And this is picked up by the Saints. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. Defense. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
So the face mask puts them in even better shape than they were in, as they'll have a short field here on first and 10. Out of the gun, Bridgewater gets it to Meredith, complete. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line. And just one man in the backfield here, that's Kamara, second and goal. To throw is Bridgewater. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. But now it's third and goal. Definitely be a disappointment to come out of this starting position with just 3 points. They need to try to dive. Got a man open. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for New Orleans. A 3-yard touchdown pass, and the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. That's why you've got your star out there. Throw the ball to him. They did.
That's simply saying we don't care what coverage you put out there. He's so good, we're going there with the football anyway, and there's not a thing you can do about it.
Inside the red zone, they go to him. He gets it done. Lutz with the extra point, and it's now 14-0. A drive there of just four plays, and it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now this offense about ready to take over again. They just did manage to sneak into the playoffs as a 6th seed, so it's a tough road ahead. They would need to win 3 games on the road in January, but there's 20 other teams who wouldn't mind being on that road.
You're exactly right about that. But your point about how daunting this is well taken, because it all depends on their mindset now. How do you break it down so that you're not looking at this whole big road and say to yourself, we've got no shot? You break it down to this game right now, win that one, then worry about the rest of them after that.
And that's exactly right, and the staff told us that. They've been focusing with the players on don't look ahead, but that's hard to do sometimes, is it not?
It is hard to do, because the ultimate goal is to do what? It's to win a Super Bowl. So you have to look ahead a little bit, but you make sure you focus on the game at hand.
Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Open man is Allison, complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
That was an excellent read right there. Saw cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on his first drive. Instead, second down. And here now, New Orleans defensive unit.
Cameron Jordan is now one of those versatile defensive linemen you can play all up and down the front. Whether he's playing tackle or end, he knows how to make plays.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
I'm coming after you.
Throwing again, Rodgers, and Graham's got it, complete. And he'll get it down here to the 43. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. Rodgers gonna try and throw on third down. And able to find Graham, complete. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Rodgers on the money to the tight end, Graham. 14 yards, good for a Packer first down. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And that'll be caught by St. Brown. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Sheldon Rankins gets him for a loss of 8. What great push up front.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead. Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. So on now for the Packers as their all-time leading scorer, Mason Crosby. This a 43-yard attempt. And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through, and they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, partner, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting 3? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you 6?
This is taken at the 3. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home, yo. Let's make these babies cry all the way back.
Bridgewater on first down. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And this will go as a gain of 7 as he gets it to the 30-yard line. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. On the counter, here's Kamara. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Defense.
So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
And now it's 1st and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Throw left side, complete. It's Murray. I call it no gain there on the first down play. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. Call it no gain on the dump off, and it's 3rd down. And they'll need the 39 here for a 1st. This is 3rd down. From the gun, Bridgewater. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on 3rd down.
Defense.
So a pretty early 1st quarter roughing the passer penalty.
Seems like the officials are going to let everyone know they're taking charge of this game. They're always going to protect the quarterback.
Now here's a pass on 1st down that's knocked away and incomplete. Blake Martinez, the linebacker, was there in coverage to disrupt. A 2nd down throw for Bridgewater. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's 3rd down.
It's 3rd and 7.
On 3rd down, Bridgewater. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces 4th down. Now Lutz for the field goal try. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked.
I bet you as they ran out there for that play, the head coach either on his headset or he pulled him aside and told the special teams coordinator, whatever block you've got, pull it out of the bag right now. We need a spark.
When you can just feel it on their sideline, the air just kind of out of the balloon, now maybe you're right, a spark, a little bit of hope.
That's when the special teams coordinator, who works on this ad nauseum, I'm talking about morning, noon, and night, he tried to figure out, okay, where's my best opportunity? Which one do I have? And he pulled the right one and got his team going and hopefully back into the game.
So now a chance for points in the opposite direction after the blocked field goal. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. Not much there, maybe a couple up to the 35. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Throwing is Rodgers. Open here is Allison. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice gain.
Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Tackle made at the 38 yard line.
Four down.
8 yards on the pickup.
On second down now, it's Jones. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
I have to admit, I'm excited by that play call and the end result, because this is a team that's down big early in the first quarter, and a lot of teams will just panic, abandon the playbook, and just start firing the ball all over the place. It's way too early for that. Stick to what works for you.
Down double digits, and we talked about their game plan being both running and passing there. You're right. They're sticking to the game plan, getting the ground game going.
A lot of football left to be played.
Now Rodgers. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And that's complete to Adams.
Rodgers pass complete to Davante Adams. A 2 yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Rip left.
After one, a 14-3 ball game. The Packers on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 8. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Cameron Jordan with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of 7.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card round. They told us the wild card could be that defensive pressure. They showed it there. So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get 3 of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue, because you know, after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get 3? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. The last time they had a little bit of a special teams breakdown, that field goal was blocked.
Yeah, and everything has to be precise in the kicking game. Snap, hold, kick. Obviously, the blocking to keep people out. So what you really want to do is get in there and get 6 points and take the pressure off of those guys.
Bridgewater. Now this is a catch by Ted Ginn. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. That throw good for 4. It's second down. On second down, Kamara.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. Right about 20 yards on the pickup. Well, officially, they'll say it's going to go for 19. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line.
Move. We got four.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
No gain on the play.
Looking to throw on second down. Bridgewater. Thomas has got it. Complete.
Complete to Michael Thomas. A gain of 2. Brings up
all that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
The Saints on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Bridgewater. Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. And he's got the first, but we also have a flag on the field.
Offense.
And they're already walking backwards. That's Ryan Ramczyk, the former first-round pick. And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. 3rd and long. Out of the gun, Bridgewater. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Roughing the passer, defense.
Well, instead of 4th down after the incompletion, it'll be 1st down, roughing the passer.
Coaches love their defenses to be aggressive, but they want them to be smart as well. Have to leave the quarterback alone at a certain point.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A good pickup there of 22.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. This quarterback now 12 of 17 through the air as he leads his guys up on 1st down. Back to the ground. It's Kamara. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. And they give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
It's now 2nd and 6.
They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6. The Saints on 3rd down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. Bridgewater now. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. The safety, Adrian Amos, comes crashing in for the sack.
How about that? One of the so-called little guys putting the pressure on. That was a strong safety. When I was in college, we often called that a lightning blitz.
So out comes a field goal team now for the 2nd time here today.
A 30-yard attempt.
And Lutz's kick is good. And that will extend their lead here to 17-6. So this time the protection holds up for him just fine, and he's able to bang it through.
I think their special teams coach got the point across. He gave him a pretty good earful after the block earlier, and this time there's no penetration, so they're able to pick up three.
This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 26. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And he finds his tight end, Graham. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards on the play there as the Packers have the first down as well.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And they try to sweep to Jones. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Throwing on second down, Rodgers, and he rifles one incomplete. They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion. From the gun, it's Rodgers. He'll get this off to Jamal Williams. Certainly not what they wanted there. No gain, and it's fourth down.
They dialed up the blitz on third down, and your worry as a defense that they can hit you with a big play in that situation. Instead, the blitz pays off, able to rally to the football and make the play.
On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. Back deep for the Saints is Ted Ginn. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And last time they were able to churn some clock, they got the field goal, added onto their lead, but that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game, but we probably should go to the post-game press conference because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive. And he's going to profess that he was happy to get points.
But
and we know that's not true.
Yeah.
Okay, after this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
So second in inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker. Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. The offense on third down tonight, they've converted four times out of six. Not bad. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. To throw is Bridgewater. And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that fell harmlessly to the ground. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. Devontae Adams and the Packer offense heading back out. With them losing here in the second quarter and his limited productivity so far, you'd have to think they're going to try to look to him a little bit more, right?
I would guess you would start to see maybe some quick screens, some hitches, anything to get the ball in his hands quickly and let him try and do some damage after the catch. Or maybe just flip some formations and keep him isolated where it's more of a one-on-one route and get the ball to him.
I say just four verts, right?
Hey, why not? Four verts. One of the best routes in football. Hard to cover each guy all the way along the route.
So far, just one catch for him. So now a fresh set of downs. First and 10 after roughing the passer. Quick throw caught out wide by Valdez-Scantling. Call it a one-yard gain on the play, and it'll make it second down. On second down, it's Jones. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. The Packers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Here's Rodgers to throw. Trying to get it to Adams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, DeMario Davis. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
Defense.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Automatic first down.
Let's go. Let's go. Interception, baby. Let's go.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10. Throwing, Bridgewater. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 12 yards there, good for a Saints first down. Now Bridgewater gets it to Meredith, complete. So he got free of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else.
Roughing the passer, defense.
So that one will be accepted. So a critical mistake, roughing the passer. Now it's 1st and goal. They'll run it with Kamara. And he'll barrel his way into the end zone for a Saint touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further.
Well, he got a little bit of everything on that run. Offensive line creating some space, but how about the guy running behind his pads into the end zone?
What does that mean when a guy says running behind his pad? It
means that he's going to be a physical runner. That way he's able to use his shoulder pads, his forearms, anything to ward off people to power his way forward.
Lutzel looked to add the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. Two plays later, pay dirt. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This one fielded at the 5. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Here's Aaron Jones in the offense trotting back out. They've given him some touches. They haven't had a lot of success on the ground. Do you maybe keep going to that well, or do you mix it up more?
I think you mix it up more, try to loosen things up. Get the defense to react to other people, other plays, but don't forget about it. That's your horse. You know, Secretariat lost twice in his career.
So educational. That's very true, kids. Look it up. Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up 2nd down. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on 3rd and a tough 9. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Sheldon Rankins able to get in there for his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Here's J.K. Scott now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Yards on the return that time, and the Saints will take over with a 1st down and 10. Teddy Bridgewater and the Saints set to take over, and he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they're feeling really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the 1st-half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down.
Well, we know he's an electric runner. Earlier this half, you were wondering how they were going to bottle him up at different levels. That was your suggestion. Some mixed results.
Yeah, certainly, because we have seen him bottled up at times. We've seen him play him very well. We've also seen him pop the cork a few times and get out of there, haven't we?
We have indeed.
From the 44, Bridgewater. Cameron Meredith, the intended target, and it's third and short. They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. From the gun, Bridgewater. And that is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Here's Thomas Morstead now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. Aaron Rodgers, we focus on him for our player spotlight. And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
And we'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. Now Rodgers out of the backfield. This is Aaron Jones. Call it a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it a second down. To throw, it's Rodgers. Open here is Allison. That's complete. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back. And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field.
It's our time.
And again, it's Rodgers. He's got his man, Valdez-Scantling. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. This is Jones. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. It's Patrick Robinson there on the stop. On second and 9, Rodgers gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. They wound up getting nothing out of that second down completion, so now here's third and 10. Throwing is Rodgers. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. Here's J.K. Scott now as he's on to punt for Green Bay. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go 4 verticals, because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently we're going to get right back to it.
But first, time to look ahead to Sunday's action here in the NFC. A 4-5 battle that ought to be a tight one, as it's going to be the Los Angeles Rams taking on the Chicago Bears.
Come on, man. Let's go.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
I feel for some of these guys nowadays because it is so tough to be able to run with these tight ends. Their speed, their elusiveness, especially when they run across the field, because you're not just running with him, you're trying to run through some traffic as well.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield.
Switch up, switch up.
And they'll try the jet sweep here. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And Graham's got it. Complete. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Officially, it will go as a one-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason, it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
Throwing now is Rodgers. And that'll be caught by St. Brown. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 35.
A gain of 14. And a first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll run it with Jones. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and four.
A 6-yard pickup brings up second and four.
From the 29, Rodgers got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. 14 yards, good for a Packer first down. Rodgers will bring him up to the line, first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. And that's complete to Adams. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Rodgers now to throw. A quick throw, but incomplete. This will be the 8th play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7. Rodgers to throw once more. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up 4.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
So his 3rd field goal of the ball game brings him a bit closer, but there's no question. They need to start turning some of these 3s into 6s.
And 7s, and probably even 8s. You know, as a kicker, you just head out when you're called upon, so he's done his job. It's the rest of the offense that needs to get it in gear. They want to close this gap.
This fielded at the 2. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. A first down throw for Bridgewater. And it's caught, the tight end Hill.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. A 10th carry for Kamara. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless. Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
The Saints first down there on a gain of 11.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, put a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Now flags will come in. And I think this is against the Saints up front. So that'll bump it back to a first and 15. A false start backs him up 5. First and 15. Bridgewater. This is caught by Ginn. And he is down at the 48. A pickup of 4 that started at 148-yard line and ended at the other. Looking to throw again on second down. Bridgewater, and it's hauled in by Jared Cook. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
On first and 10, Bridgewater. And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9.
Third down and 9.
From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. I think you'd agree that looked like the right call from up here.
No doubt about it. What everyone has to understand is that the officials are going to be right on the play each and every time. You may not like the call, but they're usually spot on.
And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. On the tackle that time, Dean Lowry. That was second down run for Murray. He gets this down to the 3, but no further. Brought the power run out of the bag and got a couple extra yards with it. Give him 8 yards there. Still a few inches to go, though, as it'll be 3rd down and about the length of the football. Completes this one to Meredith. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the 4-yard line. So instead of forcing the field goal, it'll be 1st and goal.
Yeah, the force was trying to make something happen that just didn't need to, right? I mean, the plays happen, let it go. It's over.
And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Ted Ginn there to make the grab. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. But look, this is a team, Charles. They faced adversity all year long. They had to fight and claw to win that division. But they're putting it all together here in the wild card game.
Feels like a statement, doesn't it? An absolute statement game, a message to the top seeds. Overlook us at your own peril. We're pretty darn good.
Lutz good on the extra point. And the lead opens up now to 22 points. So that one a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This will be taken in at the 1. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And now back out comes the offense.
And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about that. Super toe.
Here's Rodgers. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. To throw again, Rodgers. The connection made, it's Graham. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. To throw is Rodgers. Well, the two men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively brings up 4th down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything that warranted a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Here's J.K. Scott now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The offense and Alvin Kamara heading back onto the field. He's had a good performance, moved the ball effectively on the ground. Of course, he has the one touchdown.
And when you're able to move it as effectively as you've described, that leads to finding a way into the end zone. And now he's just trying to do it for a 2nd time. And, of course, with that comes additional yardage.
Yeah, looking for additional yardage. And, again, that 2nd score here in the 3rd quarter. Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Jared Cook, the tight end, was the target. That'll bring up 2nd down. On 2nd down, Bridgewater again. Again has it complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
Just more of the same there, partner. Guys have just been running free in the secondary this entire game. No pass rush, a lot of passes completed. Been an easy day for them.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up 1st and 10.
Our time. It's our time. Watch safety creep. Safety creeping.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on 1st down. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. From the gun, Bridgewater. And that will be incomplete.
Bridgewater's pass, intended for Alvin Kamara, incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he's on to punt for New Orleans. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this punt sails over the sideline. And the spot, it looks to be right at the 25-yard line. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field.
These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
They're throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Rodgers will try again on second down. To Valdez Scantling over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 11 yards and a Green Bay Packer first down.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage. And that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area. So you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. From the gun, it's Rodgers. This complete to Jones.
Let me see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
But these guys got to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Rodgers gonna throw, and he finds his tight end, Graham. And he will get him down a couple yards shy of the first down marker. A nice tackle coming up from his free safety spot.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Here's J.K. Scott now. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away.
Get ready, get ready, get ready.
One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now it's a bootleg with Bridgewater. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line.
That's how we do it, baby.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Third and long now after the sack. And we'll see if Bridgewater has a response. And they'll mark him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. Only a yard on the third down throw, and that leads to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Oh,
That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. And here back onto the field comes Jimmy Graham. And the numbers show it, low involvement early. But since he's been involved, it's been a good thing for this offense.
Indeed it has, and when you're able to finally get him going, get him fully integrated into the offense, things feel a whole lot better for your team. It expands everything that they do trying to move the football.
A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. 1st and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down. After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10. Here's Rodgers. Gonna throw again. And Graham's got it. Complete. And he's gonna be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Offense.
Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
On 3rd and long, it's Rodgers. It's complete to Williams. Give him 15 there, and the Packers have a first. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
So in Saints territory now, here's 1st and 10, right at the 40. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. P.J. Williams with a pick.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And they have made this look easy. I mean, there's not supposed to be anything easy about the NFL playoffs, but this lead, yes, they're at home, but this has been impressive.
And we hear all the time when upsets happen, teams go on the road, that maybe home field advantage isn't all it's cracked up to be. But you and I both know the reality is teams really fight hard to get it. Why? You don't ever have to change routine. Everything's familiar going into the game. It makes things easier, and that has paid off for them in a big way in this contest. But Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. They'll run it here. This is Buck Allen. And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the 4th quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38.
Double tight, double tight. 3 down, 3 down.
A run. It's Murray. Murray has the first down and more. And another mistake here defensively as a flag is down on the tackle. And that's going to tack on 15 more. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
And now it's first and 10, a big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. They'll run with Allen. And an alley to run. And down inside the 15 he goes. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive, they went three and out.
All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, Bridgewater. Yeah, he's got it. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Ted Ginn, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Saints able to stretch that lead out further. So another score there. Often you talk about the three phases of the game. Defense, offense, special teams. It's been a clean sweep in this one, hasn't it?
It certainly has. They've been pretty dominant throughout this game. And privately, the head coach will add a fourth phase. That's the coaching. And he'll tell the ownership that as he tries to negotiate a new contract off of this win.
They are looking strong here in the fourth quarter. Lutz with the extra point. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now. A drive that time of six plays, and it all culminates in a Saints touchdown. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they're marching off another 15 against your squad.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Now Rodgers. A dump underneath to Jones. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Rodgers now to throw, and that is incomplete. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense that's well coordinated.
And now a fumble. The ball's out. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Rodgers throwing complete here to St. Brown. And they'll get this down to the 10. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
Now a first down carry by Jones.
And flags come in as he gets forward for about 3 yards. And let's check on the call. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. And again, it's Rodgers. It's Williams on the catch. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it'll be a second and long. Rodgers again now. He'll get this one to the Golden Domer, St. Brown. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. Touchdown, Packers! Mercedes Lewis there to make the grab. And the Packers get a score closer.
There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. And that'll cut the lead down to 22.
Makes the score Saints 38.
So this drive spans 7 plays, and the result, a Green Bay score. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Saints hands team able to rein this one in. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
On first down, Murray. Tremont Williams, a veteran corner there on the stop.
Tremont Williams on the tackle.
Two times.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second and 5.
Again, it's Murray. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's a loss of 2, now third down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Now Bridgewater. And he finds Cook. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. And looking to put this game on ice in the fourth quarter, but still not afraid to throw it as they show there.
You want to play the game with confidence, and they have a guy who's in control right now. Their trigger guy throwing it, they feel just as confident with him doing that as they would if they tried to run the ball and run the clock out.
Bridgewater now looking to throw on first. Completes this one to Meredith. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Brandon, is there any way you and I can join this quarterback in the zone he's in? He's absolutely feeling it. Touchdown after touchdown, throwing the ball.
To try to add the PAT. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now.
Makes the score Saints 45.
So that drive, 4 plays, and it ends with a touchdown for New Orleans. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts of the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. The veteran tight end Mercedes Lewis, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock Alvin away and bring up second down. And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
This defense tightening up a bit. That last catch just 1 yard, making it third and nine. To throw is Rodgers. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Here's J.K. Scott now, as they're forced to kick for the sixth time today. Here's Ginn. 51 yards on the punt there. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. The outcome of this one, well, we know who's going to win it. It's just all window dressing at this point. Got me thinking, what's the biggest blowout that you've been a part of as a player, broadcaster?
Well, I'm not going to go to the player part, because when I think blowout...
Because you won every game as a player.
No. I think about being blown out. And no one wants to go back to those memories. But, you know, when I was calling college football, I saw a game that, you know, a team put 70. I actually saw it happen twice. A team put 70 on their opponent. And in the NFL in the 2017 season, I saw one of those changing of the guard games where a team that hadn't been very good before now was dominating and kicking around a team who had been ruling their division.
And that's when you earn your paycheck, right? As the analyst, you got to fill that time.
You've got to know what's going on out there and how it all happened.
Well, obviously, that begs the question, what game was it?
That was Seattle hosting Los Angeles, the Rams.
Ah, yeah.
Their second meeting of the season, and the Rams turned it around from the first one and blew out the Seahawks.
When this offense gathers to watch the tape, they're going to like a lot of what they saw. They put up big numbers, but they might fast forward through that last play.
Oh, there won't be any fast forwarding, partner. I've sat in those sessions before. You end up spending more time on the bad plays than you do on the good ones. It's just the nature of coaches. But I know sitting in that room, when you've had a big game, the night that they've had, you don't want to hear that. You just want to focus on the good stuff.
The second down play, not much better than the first, just a gain of one there.
Jair Alexander on the tackle. A gain of a yard brings up third and 10.
And a disappointing way to close out the season. He got into the playoffs but couldn't really make any noise.
Still a good season. Some might call it a great season when they get away from it a little bit, but they also will all look at their own errors, their own mistakes, and wonder how they could have played a little bit better. So if they get in this position again, they'll be ready to win.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Saints are winners here as we say so long from New Orleans.